I'm ready to go.
Welcome to Evanston Woman Today. I'm your host, LDV. We have Lisa D on the show.
May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please? Will the real Slim Shady please
stand up? This is her. It's right here.
You are funny.
There's your surprise.
So you don't normally do that for guests?
No, but you know, most people wouldn't think that I like to laugh. I don't just gripe all the time. I laugh too. So how are you?
I am just fine is the party line that I am giving right now. I'm good. Just fine. How are you?
I'm good. I found the COVID-15. So, you know, 19's here, but I found the 15. I finally 15 pounds.
I put down my cake to stop eating for the interview. I haven't stopped eating.
I saw you at Bally's. You remember when the whole thing, you were like, putting coconut milk. How are we going to do that? We're going to do it. We're going to get through it.
God. It's fine. We're going to get through it. Because of people like me and you, we will get through it.
Yes, we will. So tell us, what you've been up to lately?
Well, I have been home for 7 weeks. Mm-hmm. Right before the shutdown happened, I got let go from my job. And I don't know if you know this about me, but I have a lot of energy. Mm-hmm. Yes. For decorating, not for exercising, but for producing and planning citywide initiatives. I have a ton of production energy all the time running through me. So I've been home for 7 weeks. And the latest iteration of my neurotic free time locked in my house energy is Evanston Art Connects, a citywide freaking initiative. So, I mean, I've just been like, oh, and I've been hosting a show because I miss people and I want to talk to them. And I love that people are doing this. So I've been doing this every day at 6 o'clock.
This is great. And it's a Lisa D show, but now it's in a podcast. You're now live on Instagram, right?
No. I was doing a podcast for forever. I think like 3 people listened. One was me. And it was audio only. And then I got invited to be on my friend's Instagram live show. And my friend is Beto O'Rourke and he is totally famous. And he invited me to be on Instagram live. And I'm like, video? I don't know if I can do that. And it has opened up a whole world. I'm like, oh my God, I'm going to start a TV production company.
There you go. I want to host a show on your TV production company.
Yes. I'm like, what?
Yes. And you have the space. You have the space. And if we have to gather 10 or less, you know, or 20 or less.
And everyone's got the time. No one's like too busy to watch.
Yeah, you know, the whole thing about this whole COVID, it's kind of been giving us an opportunity to reset our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And just kind of reevaluate where we're at and saying, okay, how we're going to move forward. So mm-hmm. What's been your silver lining?
The silver lining has been the collaborating with other humans on projects. Like I have been working on Evanston Made really aggressively on our online presence with Kathy Halper and Liz Kramer. And like, they are awesome collaborators, even when we can't see in person, because we do this, we have Zoom meetings, we have deliverable lists. So like that production team has been a silver lining. And then Liz and this guy, Tiago, and myself, Tiago Velo, started doing the Lisa D show. And he, this is what's super interesting right now about COVID. I've referred to these people as grounded talent. So people who are filmmakers, sound engineers, whatever, consultants who travel the world are now locked inside at home, not working. And Tiago reached out and was like, hey, I want to produce something interesting. And someone said, you might want to do a show and blah, blah, blah. And now we're working on developing not only the Lisa D show, so like the live interview model, but we're also developing, without giving away too much, long format TV shows that we will launch with 5 to 9 of them. That'll be 15 minute in-depth interviews with Evanston artists. And I'm kind of pumped out of my mind because he's super professional and super talented and Liz is super smart and it's going to be amazing.
About your love and your passion for art and how this
New City Initiative, this New City-wide initiative came about?
Well, in general, I am very passionate about advocating for and raising awareness for Evanston artists. As you know, there are tons of them in this community, tons of creatives. I like to use the umbrella. But I really am passionate about supporting visual artists. I'm married to a visual artist. My neighbors, Amanda Evanston and friends, are all visual artists. Like, I am not. I don't make things. I make things happen. And in moving here 7 years ago, I got involved with the Evanston Arts Council and really learned what support was needed for the arts community, and then just became a citizen volunteer, totally self-appointed. No one asked. I'm like, I will do it. So in 7 years that I've been doing it, it has turned into Evanston Made, now a nonprofit membership organization. And one of the things that happened at shutdown is I started getting a lot of phone calls. I mean, I get a lot of phone calls a lot for people who are like, do you have an art studio I can rent? And or do you know anyone who will show my art at their business? But I started getting calls from community leaders who were like, what are you going to do, Lisa, for this art thing? Because we're all locked inside and you need to, like, what are you going to do? And I'm like, what am I going to do? Mm-hmm. I'm just a lady at home eating cake. What do you mean, what am I going to do? And then Jenny Rook from the Institute of Therapeutic Arts reached out with a project idea that I was like, that's cool, but let's elevate that and take it to the next level. And now she has connected me with you and 30 other community leaders from nonprofit organizations who were like, yeah, we want to do something to, you know, give a shout out to our helpers and everyone who's on the front lines in this debacle, and send out love to our graduates, all the dinkies, the kindergartners, eighth graders, and seniors who are not going to get to graduate. Mm-hmm. Break my heart in half. So everyone's going to throw this big art party and make art and share art as a way to say, like, we love you. And it's just so beautiful. Like I'm not even an emotional crier person. I'm hardcore. It, like, makes me a little weepy. That everyone, all these private citizens are just going to be like, yeah, cool. We're going to throw a huge citywide art exhibit. And then Memorial Day weekend, the SSAs, like Central Street Business District and downtown Evanston and Main Dempster Mile, are making this, like, map. And then restaurants are going to have picnics because everyone's going to be grounded and at home on Memorial Day weekend. And you can, like, walk around by yourself and go look at art all over Evanston. It's just, like, it's so beautiful. I'm so excited.
Yeah, I mean, that is going to be fun. And the nice thing is that we're going to be able to social distance, mm-hmm. in time, support artists, support our community, learn about the different nice creative work that will be going on, and mm-hmm. support restaurants at the same time. And yeah. Places like Vinic Wine, mm-hmm. and Wine Goddess, which I'm now going to go get one of those little station wagons you pull.
To have a little roadie. People are like, how do I get involved? It's very simple. You make a thing of artistic value of something, like whether it's yarn or drawing or whatever, you make a thing, you hang it in a window, and you take a picture of it and you upload it to social media with the hashtag Evanston Art Connects.
And they can also hashtag Evanston Made.
And hashtag Evanston Made, kindness in action, Evanston, yeah. Art. It's like, we'll curate all of this and then put everything online so people can, let's say you can't go walk around because you're at home and you're 82 and you don't want to put yourself at risk. Everything will also be online. So we'll have a citywide art exhibit that you can see in person and online. It's going to be very, very cool.
That is. That's very heartfelt. It kind of unifies us, you know, it brings us together all in one. One thing in common. And we do need that right now.
So badly. To make it equitable, to make it so that everybody gets to participate regardless of their artistic level, we're also making and giving away free art kits. So basic art materials like pens, colored pencils, crayons, paper, scissors. We're going to be dropping them off at the food distribution centers for District 65. We're going to be dropping them off at, like, the Levy Center. We're going to have certain drop points that will let everybody know. But the organization Kids Create Change and Art Makers Outpost are, I told them, excuse me, I'd love to give away 50,000 art kits. And they're like, you're insane. and I'm like, whatever, we'll aim high and see what happens. And then, you know, we're talking to people like Byline Bank and Northwestern funding the whole thing. So it's like, there's just so many people who are stepping up to make this happen. It's so awesome. And I'm thinking too, if we all work so hard to produce this big art thing, you know, we're not taking down the art June 10th. I have a feeling that the art's gonna remain up. Granted, some of it will sell because it'll be inside, you know, a fancy restaurant window, but there's no reason why we cannot, for the next couple of months, in a therapeutic, mental health, community building way, just make art all summer long and just art bomb the entire town all summer long. And if we can get someone to supply a bunch of art kits, who wouldn't be making art all summer? Kids can't go to camp. Don't make me cry. So.
You're making this happen, Lisa. You are Lisa D from the Lisa D Show. And Lisa, the art lady, and Lisa.
And I am the real Slim Shady, so don't try to come up in here.
All right, well, thank you for being with us today, and we'll definitely plug this in and start promoting. All right, Lisa.
Nice to see you. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye-bye.